Hi there, class of 2021 and 22 parent. Deacon John Wilson here, Education Enrichment Director for West Angeles Church. I guess I'm especially talking to class of 2022 parents whose students just finished the first semester. A lot of you have not returned for me to do your FAFSAs. That's fine. If you do need to, get back to me soon. There's such a low number this year. I'm thinking there'll be a lot of you all at once, but get to me and I'll be glad to do it. But that being said, even if you're doing it on your own, and even if I'm doing it, you really need to, right now, request your students' first semester grades. You know, before you start doing a FAFSA for next year, the schools are pressuring you to do that because they know that once you file it, they're committed for a year. For another year. And you need to look at those grades. So if I need to talk to your student about their grades, develop a study plan, there's still time before they start the second semester, or for them to give you a plan for reversing their grades. Because if their grades are not so good, they could get put on probation or already be on probation. And they don't have to tell you, they're told directly by the school. If they don't get it so that their first two semesters are 2.0 average, it's like if they're 1.2 the first semester or even 1.5, they have to be 2.5 or 3.0 sometimes the second semester in order to not be put out of school. And if it's quarters, they could be put out before the end of the year. So you should make sure their grades are good. Things come up. I've had some great students in college have very poor first two semesters, first quarter or two. That's not uncommon. Then they get their groove and they find out what they need to correct. But the only time you'll get a chance to do this is right before you file that FAFSA, when they know you have leverage and you can decide not to put the FAFSA through. It's up to you. It's your signature. So I really need you to ask for those report cards. Look at them. Make sure the student's doing well. Have a conversation. I know they don't like to talk about it, but you're the only one to hold them accountable. And they probably hate it, but you're paying for college. Or they're standing home with you when they're home. So you have a right to know, and they should be transparent about their grades. Now, parents, we got to be reasonable, too. I mean, if they've been an A student all along and now they're coming home with B's and C's, yeah, you probably shouldn't say anything. That's very normal. They'll turn it around and, 99 out of 100 times. But if they're failing or under 2.0, which means they're on probation, you need to have a serious discussion with them and something needs to change in the next semester. If you need me to speak with them and develop a plan, I have some great workers working for me that can call them and check on them during the semester and help them academically. Let's get them the support they need on the campus right now if they're not getting good grades. And once again, parents, if you need me to do the FAFSA, let me know as soon as possible, and I'll send you a link to complete the data sheet so I can get this year's FAFSA done. If you need the login information, I have that too, if I did it for you last year. All right, parents, God bless you. Happy New Year. Get a hold of me if you need anything in regards to the FAFSA. But look at those grades. Hold the students accountable for their academic performance. God bless you. And by the way, if they did well, tell them congratulations, take them out to their favorite restaurant. Bye-bye now.